He's been tagged as Western Visayas' drug lord for decades. But last week, businessman Melvin Odicta Sr. met with Interior Secretary Mike Sueño in Camp Crame to clear his name.
Sabi nila, their life is threatened in Iloilo. Marami daw may mga pumupunta sa kanila na parang tinatakot na baka magpunta dito ang pulis at saka mag-akto kayong lumaban, mapapatay kayo. So, every now and then, may pumupunta sa kanila, may nag-attack sa kanila. So, they fear for their lives. So, they went to the regional director.
Yet, National Police Chief Ronald De La Rosa wasn't having any of it. Speaking before cops in Camp Delgado in Iloilo City last week, De La Rosa took a swipe at Odicta for denying drug operations in the region.
Dinideny na hindi daw siya drug lord. Ano siya? Sinong niloloko niya?
De La Rosa did not name Odicta during his speech, but during a round of questions with the media, he confirmed that he was indeed taking aim at Odicta.
Kat, anong sabihin mo? Kilala-kilala ka naman sa buong bayan kung sino ka. Hindi na kailangan pang magtanong kung ano ka at sino ka. Oh, dagon ang tawag dito sa kanya, di ba?
But who exactly is the Ilonggo businessman for the PNP? Intel reports reveal that police tagged Melvin Odicta Sr., also known aliases Boyet and Dulo, as the brains behind the Odicta gang, with about 43 members identified, all allegedly operating in Region 6. The intel reports also reveal that Odicta was already arrested way back in March 6, 1989 for selling marijuana by narcom agents in an entrapment operation in Iloilo. December that year, Odicta was sentenced to a life behind bars. The Supreme Court upheld that decision in 1991 and ordered Odicta to be detained at the new Bilibid prisons. Odicta then made contact with big-time crystal meth or shabu dealers while at the NBP. According to the PNP, after a few years, Odicta was released after a legislative change downgraded penalties. But the PNP noted that there are no documents on hand to prove that Odicta availed of a reduced sentence. 1997 was when Odicta allegedly revived his drug operations. A year after, Odicta met Miriam Poras, a widow of Bonjing Poras, another alleged drug personality. They fell in love but remained unwed. September 7, 2000, police raided the couple's home in Barangay Malipayon, Iloilo, but the operation yielded negative results. Charges against Odicta were dropped. In 2003, Odicta voluntarily presented himself to the Iloilo City Police to clear his name, saying that he wanted to live a peaceful life and help police with their anti-illegal drugs campaign. But the PNP noted that since then, they still receive reports that Odicta remains as a source of illegal drugs in Iloilo. However, they didn't have any evidence to pin him down.
Alam nyo kasi, yung drug lord, napakahirap hulihin. Hindi sila humahawak ng drugs. Sila'y taga-distribute lang ng drugs. Taga-order na taga-distribute.
Jeff Canoy, ABS-CBN News.